another episode of Radiant Astoria. Today we're checking out some alternate timelines. It's been a while since I've done Nemesia's mission, so she probably is a bunch stacked
up. I picked up reading on a new artifact.
I'm sure you have. Probably a lot of them. Oh, wow. Are these all of them? Are these all the ones I need to catch up? That's quite a few. We're gonna do a couple today. Not too long there, but let's see the possible outcomes. I guess we'll work our way down from the top. Somebody with an artifact is in serious danger. Go rescue them and retrieve the artifact stock. Alright.
Ready for your next assignment?
Let's see what possible world this is.
The next potential world is in real danger. Please save them if you can.
I will. You can count on me.
Good luck, and have a safe trip.
Alright, thank you, Nemesia. Alright. Our first mission for today. I've only done one of our missions before, so this feels like a weird, like, new experience being back doing our missions. Echoing Scream. Plus, I haven't played in a while, so that's a thing, too. So it's pretty nice to be back.
This is Grand Plain. I need to find that artifact. Fast.
No! Please don't do this!
Did you hear that? Someone screaming.
That was Lise. I'm positive.
What? Come on, let's rescue her.
Right.
Oh no, it's Lee's getting attacked. Does she have the artifact in this timeline? Don't want to save here. No, I'm gonna run through. Alright, how do I swing my sword again? I've forgotten everything, guys. I've forgotten it all. Is she up here? Where is she? Oops, not you.
Here it comes.
She over here? Oh wait, is she straight up?
Can't we talk this over? Violence won't solve a thing.
Wait, why would Terraquin want to capture Banos and Lise? It doesn't make sense.
But...
shut up, my business is ruined. I'm drowning in debt. I have no choice.
Let them go. Right now!
That reaction earlier, Banos must have the artifact. I'll deal with that later,
That's
though.
Enough. This violence isn't like you.
And who the hell are you? Don't talk like you know me.
Tell me what you plan to do with those captured Sataros.
But
I need their horns. I'll fetch a pretty penny from collectors.
You're selling our horns?
That's not allowed.
Stop right there. You dare move a muscle and I'll blow you all to smithereens.
He seems unstable.
What do we do?
We could ignore his threats. But what if he's serious?
Would Terraquin really go through with it? I just don't know. I should think this over direction or wait it out and mull over my other options. We could blow it up anyway. I'll try to stay back for now. Maybe I should wait and see how things play out, huh? Stay back for a second.
This would be over quick if we could just catch Tarkin off guard. But how do we do that?
Stuck. Look, a beast.
Maybe we could lure it over to Tarkin somehow.
How do we do that?
I know! Those guys are crazy about tasting meat, but we don't have any.
Looks like I need to go find some meat. What are you yammering on about? Back off or I'll blow them all.
Let's retreat for now while we figure this out.
Recklessness has been added to the White Chronicle. Okay, so I went back to this earlier note and I'm pretty sure this one is where we can get the boy meat if we go down from here. There is a boy we have to fight back at this point after we collect the firewood, so I'm pretty sure if we go fight this thing again, it should give us the boy meat we need to complete Nemesia's mission. It's very old. And I'm pretty sure there is, yep, the final piece of what we were looking for. So we gotta grab and then a boy comes up to us and he wants to fight and... We need boy meat. Alright, let's take him out. Alright, let's go with, how tough is he gonna be? Whoa, what's even good in this dude? What was good in the last one? Fire? Alright, fire. I got plenty of fire. We got a heat blade, and we also have giga fire, so we'll probably destroy him this time around.
Fire!
Oh, yups. Yep, he's going down pretty fast. This won't take too long. We'll be able to go back to Nemesia very fast. Gotta take this guy out. There's also a mushroom at the back. I'll just use some fire magic and... You have no MP. Okay, maybe it'll take a little bit longer without your MP,
be over back? Quick if we could just catch Tarkin off guard. But how do we do that?
Stuck. Look, a beast.
Okay, we got the meat, so we should be able to lure him over this time.
Maybe we could lure it over to Tarkin somehow. I have an idea. Everyone, follow my lead.
Got it. But what's the plan?
We use this.
Tasty meat!
Hey, catch!
But
what, the meat? How is this supposed to fix anything? Okay. Oh, what was that? Oh, don't tell me! X, just stay away. If you don't, I'll detonate the... Hey, get away from me!
Whoa, it worked!
Here, yeah.
There goes the beast.
I didn't expect you to have meat on hand, Stock.
I suppose I got lucky.
You totally didn't plan that out or anything.
You saved our lives. How can I ever repay you? I know. It isn't much, but please accept it.
Red pottery.
That was a close shave, but now we can head to Granorn. Thank you so very much.
No problemo. Survival of the fittest has been absolutely comical. Is that your mission complete? Yeah, we did it, Ari. That one wasn't too difficult once you know where to get the
Welcome
boy meat.
Welcome aboard, Stock. How'd it go? You're not hurt, are you?
I'm fine. Don't worry. As for the artifact, here you go.
Hand it over red pottery.
Spot on. Thank you, Stock.
Quest complete. Yay! Yeah, shield fruit. HP and MP have been restored. Oh, thank you. That's nice of you.
Let's put on our thing.
All right, yeah, let's do another mission. Okay, the Prophet speaks. Some shady business going down in one possible Alistair. If I had to guess an artifact's involved, get in there and check it out.
Ready for your next...
Alright, let's do this one next.
You're going to a potential
on
Alistair, but I've got a bad feeling about this one. Someone could be abusing the artifact to throw the timeline into chaos. It's only a hypothesis, but be careful out there. And please bring back the artifact safely.
Alright, let's go. Let's hope we can figure this one out. Promise to be on time. Wait, no, it was the Prophet Speaks, the one I picked. That was another name I read in the list. Amini's here.
People seem uneasy.
Probably sick of waiting for the Prophet's speech. Everyone's gathered at the square for it. I mean, I'd go too if we weren't busy.
Noah's giving a speech?
Where's Mark anyway? He's late. I know Heiss wanted to talk to him, but still.
He'll be here soon enough, I'm sure. Shall we take a look around the square until then?
Sure. A little peek can't hurt, right?
This will be my first time actually seeing the Papa No in the flesh. To think we could hear the Prophet's words with our very own ears. What a blessed day. General Hugo is here too, so is that the Prophet Noah? I have never seen him before. So that's Noah, as elegant as I'd expect for the founder of Alistair.
My.
He should be over 90 by now, but he's still got a spring in his step. He's a walking miracle. Admiral, please have a...
The Prophet Noah wishes to address his loyal followers.
Hey!
Shh, quiet, the Prophet's about to speak.
Over 70 years have passed since I left Granorg to found Alistair.
He looks really young. Why does he look so young? They said he's supposed to be well over 90. 90-year-olds don't look like that.
Generations of Granorgite kings have come and gone since then. Yet not one of them has placed their subjects above themselves. A sad state of affairs, indeed. To this day, Granorg stokes the flames of war, while its people cry out for peace. Many Granorgite civilians are suffering, even as we speak. But I ask you, should innocent people have to pay for the sins of their monarch? I say no more! We must offer them salvation and put a stop to the bloodshed. That is why we fight. To defend Alistel and to rescue Granorg. And so I promise that we shall emerge victorious. Not to win the battle, but to end the war.
That's right.
Half of the time, let's take Granorg back from Queen Protea. Our victory will serve the Granorgites too. Praise be to the Prophet Noah.
Hooray!
Long live the Prophet. Long live Noah.
I'm back with Heis's orders.
What did he say?
Well, the details are a little shocking. Just stay calm and hear me out, okay?
So we're still working for Heis in this timeline?
According to Heis, someone is planning to assassinate the Prophet.
No way!
And, the one behind it is a master of disguise. There's a high chance he's already snuck into Alistel.
This nation will surely descend into chaos if Noah is killed. I wouldn't be surprised if the assassin had an artifact.
If that's true, then...
Yeah. We'll be in big trouble if we don't find him before the end of Noah's speech.
What if he's hiding in the crowd right this second?
No chance. The soldiers would seal the square off if anything were to happen to Noah. A skilled assassin would never risk carrying out his plan somewhere so problematic.
Where is he, then?
Well, it would have to be somewhere with a clear view into the square and to Noah. A castle window would be the perfect place to sit and wait for the opportune moment.
Makes sense to me, but how do we go about finding which window?
Few rooms actually overlook the square. We'll have to check all of them to be safe. The assassin may be disguised as the owner of the room, though. Don't let your guard down.
Is this where they showed Raoul a while ago? I'm gonna go check Raoul's room. It's one of these, because they seem to show him, so I feel like it could be his room. Reaction, is that me, Lieutenant General Raoul, is the artifact?
Who are you?
Sir? You don't recognize me? No matter. Have you heard any news from Rosh regarding his arm?
How do you mean?
I'm speaking of the Thaumatec gauntlet on his right arm. Have you heard any updates?
Yes. Nothing at the moment. Regardless, I haven't the time for discussion right now. You'll have to excuse me.
All right, out with it. Who are you? I know you're not really Lieutenant General Raoul. The real Lieutenant General would have known that Rosh's gauntlet is on his left arm. He's under your direct command, after all.
Damn! I didn't think anyone would see through my relic's cloaking.
Perhaps you should have done more research on the man you were pretending to be.
It really was a disguise.
Huh. Well, we can do more than that. I'll deal with you first. Multiply! Oh, we're gonna have to fight this guy now.
I wanna help too.
At first I was worried it was actually Lieutenant Raoul, but I'm glad it's not, cause that would have been really heartbreaking if it was, cause he seems really nice in the actual current storyline. Alright, so how do I wanna deal with these guys? Let's start with double slash in the first one. Oh, they're not too strong, actually, it looks like.
Eat this!
Yeah, at least the ones in the front row aren't that strong, so we might be able to get through this without too much trouble, hopefully. We also have Giga Thunder. Let's try use on this guy back here. And you can hit the guy in the front. You still barely do any damage, you are. Go! What a shame! And Gafka's on our team. How does that work in this timeline? How did Gafka end up with us? Interesting, I guess.
Too slow!
Alright, we're almost to get that one. Okay, two down.
Too slow!
Yeah, why is the only team in this timeline? How did this happen? I don't really know, but I like the mix up with the different timelines now. Different people are with us for them. This is pretty cool. Alright, we're gonna go for a long enough combo attack. Just as long as he can multiply mid-battle. That would be a problem if he could multiply mid-battle. Let's go for a double slash, that might speed up the process, and Erica's on our team! How's this work?
Too slow!
I don't know if these timelines have, like, different teams that, like, are actually with us in the timeline, or if they just let us use our own you're not totally sure how it works. But how it works is pretty interesting.
Make way!
And Roush is apparently with us too. Why would we ask what Roush is on our team?
It's finally over.
I got him.
Damn it.
I can't believe I failed.
We did it. We captured the assassin who was planning to kill Noah. Still, it was eerie how well he imitated Lieutenant General Raoul.
Yeah. If Stock hadn't come up with that trick question, I don't think we could have known. Well, mission accomplished. Let's go tell Heiss.
As the artifact, obtained Red Mask. Good plan has been actually conical.
Great. We have the artifact, and Noah is safe. His speech should be just about over as well. Am I imagining things, or did Noah just look at me?
Well, we're getting taken away now. I'm curious
Welcome back, Star. Well, did you find the artifact?
I did. Here you go.
Here's the
Thanks, Doc. A-plus work. We're now one step closer to undoing the desertification.
Yay! Quest complete! Two down! I got lots of cash, and now we're getting healed!
So what possibilities did that world present?
Noah himself was leading the people of Alistel. Somebody was out for his head, though.
Good job preventing it, then. Do you want a gold star?
Yeah!
No thanks. I'm all right.
Come on, Stock. Don't be such a killjoy right here.
Fine. You get a red X instead.
Oh, oh,
Star. Perfect timing. I've picked up a reading on a new artifact.
Oh, another new artifact? City in Fear. The study will be going to Alistel where people are being affected by the artifact's power. Find or achieve the artifact as soon as humanly possible. I'm gonna just work my way down from the top. I promise me on time. I'm located in artifact, but the signal seems weak for some reason. Maybe I should go with you for a change this time.
Ready for your next assignment?
Yay!
The reading I'm getting from the next artifact is a weak one. Mind if I come with you?
Alright, but are you sure?
Don't worry, it'll be fine. Come on now, let's head in.
Alright, here we go! To the next artifact. Promise me on time. This is the name I read off earlier.
Where are we now? The back streets of Granorg?
Seems like it. Which reminds me, Stock, how much do you know about this country's history?
Only as much as necessary for my job.
Then allow me to enlighten you. Knowledge is power, after all. The Kingdom of Granorg was founded about 150 years ago. The surprise is, who founded it? His name was Allium, the last prince of the Fallen Empire. Then again, anyone who's done their research would know that, so it's not really a surprise. Nevertheless, Prince Allium was... Oh, I'm sorry. Got carried away. Let's save the history lesson for another time, shall we?
Let's. Now then, you have an idea of where the artifact is. My prism has yet to react.
Let's see. Beyond that door, I think? But the signal's weak, and something is odd about it.
That's the tavern. Come, let's take a look inside.
Okay.
Will you shield me? Oh, she's not on my team, she's just traveling with me. Huh? Like the bandits and those wands supposed to be compared to their mugshots, they look kind of stupid. There's also a safe point right here, actually. That's interesting. Or a node.
Welcome.
Welcome to the Eldorado. Go ahead, kick back and relax. Huh? Never seen that merchant around here before. How suspicious, you?
Wanna buy something?
Just hey, you two, I got some rare jewelry for you. This here is an extremely valuable locket chain. Just the chain itself, but from what I hear, it once belonged to a royal bloodline.
Oh, may I take a look at it?
Yeah.
Of course, but Hans will care. You break it, you buy it.
Wanna buy something?
How about it? Sure, it's just a chain, but still a rare find at a good price. The prism seems to be having a faint reaction.
But we'll pass for now.
How could you dismiss it so easily?
That one was a big no-no. My reading picked it up, but it's only a chain. Prolonged exposure to an artifact must have transferred some of its power.
That would explain why there was only a faint reaction. By that logic, I'd expect the locket which belongs to that chain is our artifact.
I might have some insight into that. I read about it in some dusty old tome or another. According to the records, the locket could be opened up to hide important objects inside.
So the artifact may actually be housed inside the locket.
That's right. I also have a hunch on where to find it. Hey, Stock, is there any way we could get beneath the palace?
The underground waterway should work, but we'll have to be cautious down there.
An underground waterway? Even I've never read about that.
This should be a good learning opportunity then. Let's go.
We're down here now. Stuff's in such a hurry and Amasia's just taking her time. Hey, where are you going? Well, we made it.
So this is where it leads. That means the underground library is right this way.
First the locket, now this underground library. You know quite a bit about this place.
It's all thanks to my extensive research into Granarg's history. The palace's construction is a fascinating topic of study. That aside, it was a good idea to bring me along, wasn't it?
Seems it was. In any case, we should continue onward. Are you sure this is the place?
According to my research, the prince and princess of the Empire used to exchange secret notes hidden inside a locket. No matter where they were, they always exchanged their messages inside a library. That's what I read anyway. Since this is the only library in Granorg, it should be here.
It's incredible how thorough your research is, Nemesia.
Historians are nothing if not curious. Secrets of the past are what make us tick.
Good to know. Anyway, let's split up and search for that locket.
No need for that. I have an idea of where it's hidden as well. It's not here. But why? Third row down from the top on the far right. It was always here.
Perhaps it's been moved. That would explain why the prism isn't reacting.
But where else could it be?
What if the locket really is supposed to be like the Maskia says?
Something in the original history changed where the locket is in this one.
The missing locket is gonna answer like Kanako. Alright, let's
see. Sorry, Stock. Could you look into what happened and why? I'll be counting on you.
Is there anything else around here? Okay, I think we're gonna have to go to the other timeline. Is what it seems like. Yep, looks like we might be going to the other timeline. Hey, let's use this. Go to Historia. Where are we going to exactly? White Chronicle. Great, so here's the missing locket. Well, maybe we should go to the original world. I believe it's in the How to Disappear node, because it's... We're in the castle in that node, so we should be able to get to the library. And maybe we can find something out from the library. In this node, let's find out. Alright, where's the library? Is the library at the end here? The hallway here? Yep, here it is. Is it you? Did you move it? Boy, look at me. Who'd have thought I'd find a pendant among these dusty old books?
Hey, you. What are you doing?
I'm saying, please don't tell anyone. My pig got cut because of Protea, so I'm desperate for the money. I was gonna sell some books, and I just happened to find this fancy-looking pendant. I just got carried away, you know?
Enough excuses. Just put it back and get out of here.
Okay, boss, just keep this between you and me. Are we gonna take it?
The pendant should be where it belongs over in the other world. That reminds me. Nemesia said you can put stuff inside. Maybe I'll take a look. Well, that opened easily. Now then, let's see what's in here. A note. Nemesia did say the prince and princess used to use this to exchange messages. It's written in ancient script, though. Maybe Nemesia can help me translate it later.
The missing lock is where it lies in the Lake Conical. Okay, so we don't take the pendant from here, but if we go back to the other timeline, it should be there, so I'll see you guys over there.
Eureka!
Alright, we're back over here, and Eureka, look!
While I open it up.
Any sign of the artifact?
Bingo! And there's a note inside.
What does it say?
I'll try reading it. Can you hold on to this for me?
Obtained Red Crest.
In this note is written Prince Allium's farewell to his sister, whom he'd never see again. It explains how their home, the Empire, fell into ruin when it was drained of all mana, and how Prince Allium had no choice but to leave his home behind to found Granor. It ends with a promise to make things right.
So that's how he became the first king of Granorg, huh?
The prince vowed to his sister that he'd save the continent, even if it cost him his life.
Aww.
Even his life? How grim.
Whether he found such a solution is one of history's mysteries. Still, I wonder why the artifact was hidden inside this locket.
Perhaps the prince thought it would prove useful to someone. And he wasn't wrong, now that it's come into our possession.
Yeah, you're right.
The princess lost it's lost the wish, has been added to Lake Conical. And back to Nemesia's ship. That's another mission down.
And we're back. Things didn't go smoothly, but I still had fun.
As did I. Oh, I should give you this.
A+ memory stock. Thanks.
You could have just stolen it. That's another mission complete. We got a growth box. I'm sure it's useful, whatever it is. I'll check what it does in the back.
Oh, perfect timing. I've picked up a reading on a new artifact.
Oh, another new one? I guess when you complete some of these, it also opens up other missions. Let's go
ready
with Paul
for your
next
assignment? Next.
This
you gotta
time, complete them all.
We're taking a trip to the Grand Plain. Alistel and Granorg are both marching their armies there. I'm getting an artifact reading from the battlefield.
Sounds serious.
Well, be careful on your way.
Alright, let's go! So we're going right into the middle of battle here. Ball Machine Rampage. Marco and Rainier here. I'm a squad. This is a sound fortune. I suppose the artifact we're looking for is near here. I should try to get a read on the situation soon. This is a war zone after
you
all.
You know, I heard that Fennel has gone out on the battlefield himself this time.
Whoa, really? What?
I don't know the details, but a number of thaw machines have been deployed. Might be related.
We have an emergency!
So somebody help! Fennel's thaw machines are going berserk!
What?
That's pretty bad, isn't it?
Come. We should go look into this firsthand.
Oh no. No one said it would go berserk. What are we supposed to do? We're losing man. I can't believe this. Where's Fennel? He's the only one who can fix it.
What a mess. We haven't even touched Granorg yet. What should we do, Stock?
Fennel is the one who knows all about these thaw machines. If anyone can fix this problem, it's him. We should hurry.
I'm hurrying, but what do I do? Do I hurry to where the doll machines are? Well, here's Fennel.
We need to talk. If you can't get your thaw machines under control, we'll be...
Dick, car, check, car, Hey, doesn't this guy sound kinda busted?
Sure seems like it. That was nothing but strange noises. Wait, did he go berserk like those thaw machines? He has a mechanical body, too.
Oh.
What now?
Why don't we smack him? That's how I always fix stuff.
Same.
Considering his body, maybe there's an emergency shutdown switch somewhere.
Should I give him a good smack like Rainy suggested? Or should I perhaps search for the emergency shutdown as Miracle was mentioning? I have to think about this one carefully. Let's try to see if we can shut him down. Alright, I'll search for the emergency shutdown, wherever it is. Is that what I want to do? Alright, who knows what would happen to his circuitry if I really smacked him.
Fennel, I need you to listen to me. Where on your body is the emergency shutdown?
No way am I getting information out of him like this. Maybe I should go try talk to him in my history's also instead. I want to take over his man, Sonic Chronicle. Okay, so we're gonna have to go searching through the timelines again. Alright, go to Historia, let's travel. Let's see what we can find out. It's probably one of the early chapters, I'm pretty sure. Because, as far as I remember, we're not really in Alice so much after the early chapters. You know what? Maybe right here would be a good point. Let's go here. I know we can definitely approach him early on. So let's hop over to this note. Yeah, this is where we're in this room, and he's in the room next door, and I talked to him a few times. So I should be able to speak to him and see if I can figure something out.
Fennel, can I bother you for a second? I'm interested in the mechanization of your body. What do you do if it malfunctions? Does it malfunction?
It's possible, but rare. Always perform regular maintenance, and it won't be a problem.
But hypothetically speaking, what happens if the machine starts acting up?
Well, were that the case, I would need to perform a reboot.
And how do you do that?
I can't just tell you that. It's highly classified information. If you want to know that badly, I'll give you a body like mine. Then you can see for yourself.
I think I'll have to decline that offer. Anyway, sorry to have taken your time.
Looks like I'll have to try something else.
Yes.
You there, wait a second.
Indeed.
You were talking about rebooting Fennel, yes? I may actually have a lead that can help you.
That would be much appreciated.
Indeed.
I was asking this very thing myself as your sponsor was.
In the event of an emergency, I placed a certain something in the medical office. I can't just leave it lying around. So I've hidden it with Thaumatec. It'd be absolutely impossible for a petty thief to find. Magnificent means of protecting confidential material, wouldn't you say?
He seemed rather confident, so I don't expect it to be found by just anyone. I actually tried looking for it myself, but didn't see a thing. Worth a shot, I should check out the medical office. Right, it's been revised in the White Chronicle. Okay, so the medical office is right here. Oh, is this it?
Is this what he was talking about? There's something written on this paper.
Automatic Fennel Type 2 OS can be overridden via the panel on the back of the head. You wish to reboot the unit and put the code 1414. Okay, now I can reboot Fennel. Automatic Takeover has been revised. And I should be able to go back to the other timeline now and complete this mission. Alright, we're back. Let's shut him down. I'll search for the emergency shutdown wherever it is. Yes, that is what you want to do. Right, who knows what would happen to a circuitry if I really smacked him?
Right. The manual said to access a panel on the back of his head to reboot. Here it is. All I need to do now is enter the right code. I think it's,
One, four, one, four.
That should do the trick.
Oh, no.
Losing control of myself was troubling, to say the least.
What was it that caused you to go haywire?
Well, I attempted to integrate this mystical object into my operating system.
That's an artifact.
I believed it would allow me to control multiple Thaw machines at the same time. But it appears that was a miscalculation.
You could have killed someone, you know. Here, I'll be holding on to that from now on.
Red Disk!
I'm done with it anyway. Yeah. Perhaps if I scale down that sensation, I may effectively use the Thaw machines to do my bidding.
Off he goes, mumbling to himself. Is he going to experiment again with what he's learned today?
Jeez, all that trouble and he hasn't changed a bit.
Well, the Thaw machines seem to have calmed down, so at least this case is closed.
Mark and I should go see if anyone's hurt. You okay with that, Stock?
Of course.
A troubled reboot has been added to the Lake Conical. Another story has been added to the Lake Conical. I am back to Nemesia we go. It's quite convenient they always leave us behind at the end of these. It's like
welcome
no back
aboard,
to Nemesia.
I trust you've got something for me?
I do. Here you go.
And here's Red Disk.
A plus. Thank you, Stock.
Yay, another mission down. I get a machine stud. And healing. Whoa. Alright, I guess we'll
danger
do more of our missions.
Artifacts go hand in hand.
I guess we'll do more of our missions in the next episode. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day. And I